le journal qu'ils ont attaqué.
I think the magazine that they attacked was symbolic of what this radical and terrorist movement hates. That is a satirical magazine, which is in fact a brotherly magazine, run by people devoid of hate, of prejudice, respectful of others, but who use all the resources of their freedom of expression to ridicule what is ridicule, to criticize religions when they are ridiculous. There was something like that in Charlie, that ability to talk about tragic things, but to make you laugh all the same. And that's what they wanted to kill.
This wasn't the first time that the magazine had been targeted. Were you expecting something like this?
The magazine was threatened during my time there, especially after we published the caricatures of Mohammed. And from that moment, we worked under police protection. That was 8 years ago. 7 or 8 years ago. 8 years. And I already found that horrific, that simply for writing things which are perfectly normal in a democracy, we were under police protection.
Voilà, je pense aussi que on a mal.
Well, we did not read this phenomenon correctly in the UK any more than in France, I think. We took precautions so as not to, as we say, stigmatize a community. And we have given extremist parties a monopoly on speaking about how things really are. We tried to sound the alarm, raise awareness of these questions. But there you go, it has taken many years and now 12 dead for us to appreciate the problem.
Maintenant 12 morts pour que on prenne conscience du problème.
For a long time, much of the media has been rather reticent, scared to satirize Islam. Do you think there's been a double standard?
Si on ne publie pas les choses qui relèvent de la liberté d'expression, ça veut dire
if we chose not to publish things which highlights and celebrate freedom of expression, it means that we have abandoned the freedom of expression.
Ça veut dire qu'on va perdre.
Do you know what threatens democracy the most? Silence. To reduce ourselves to silence means that we will lose all that we have gained of liberty, freedom for women, for homosexuals, the freedom to come and go as we please, moral freedom. But we must not believe that the Muslims who today are outraged by what has happened cannot understand it. They can understand it. They can understand. They can understand that today their religion needs to reform, so it does not, in the heart of the democracy where they have chosen to live, create terrorists, terrorism, which is of course opposed by most Muslims, who are victims of it. For example, at the magazine, there was a proofreader that I knew very well because he was there already during my time as editor, Mustafa, a wonderful man, an extraordinary man, who was one of those who died yesterday. Muslims are victims of what is happening in their community.
You had many friends amongst those who died yesterday. Have you spoken to their families?
J'y vais là.
I'll get there.
Oui.
Vous savez, ici il y avait.
Do you know, there was someone here in France amongst them who was a model of kindness, of respect for others, and who was an incredibly talented artist with a freedom, Cabu, who died yesterday. He has been my friend for 40 years. And he is a magnificent artist. But really, beyond his talent as a satirist, he was valuable to all the world as an artist, for all artists in the world. I've done work all over the world where I've met many of my colleagues, and all of them have a deep respect for him. We lost something so precious with the people who died yesterday. It is irreplaceable. It's a crime against our humanity. Another artist who died yesterday, Volinsky, a friend, a marvelous man, used to say that the shortest path from one man to another is laughter. That's what they wanted to kill.
C'est ça qu'ils ont voulu tuer.